Hi, my name is John Francis. Thank you for joining me during this introduction of ArcFlash Auto Evaluation, a solution used to automatically evaluate ArcFlash incident energy against equipment boundary limits and damage points. When performing protection and coordination studies, it is difficult to anticipate potential ArcFlash and coordination issues due to the differences between the arc and bolted fault currents. ArcFlash Auto Evaluation automatically evaluates ArcFlash incident energy and equipment ArcFlash damage points to quickly resolve these conflicts, limiting the number of scenarios required or even removing the need for an isolated ArcFlash study. During this presentation, I will discuss some of the challenges of an ArcFlash study. We will look at incident energy evaluation within TCCs, the technology of ArcFlash Auto Evaluation, and the benefits received from using this innovative technology. Budget constraints are a challenge we all have to face. However, when it comes to safety, ideally this should not be the case. ArcFlash Auto Evaluation is a solution developed to address the budget concerns within the industry. We will overcome challenges such as no budget for equipment below 480 volts, or in certain countries, ArcFlash is completely out of scope, but the engineering and management team know that safety is a priority and should still be assessed. For projects that do require ArcFlash, many of us are faced with an increase in time spent on the additional parameters required by IEEE 1584 2018 edition. Some of these parameters are difficult to collect from the field, and many people use typical data, which historically may not have produced worst-case results. Let's use ArcFlash Auto Evaluation to overcome these challenges. ETAP C area plots, or otherwise known as constant energy boundary areas, can mitigate the ArcFlash results at the coordination stage. This graphical representation provides a reference boundary based on user-defined incident energy limits. It allows a protection engineer to consider multiple operating conditions and variations in the way an ArcFlash could occur within electrical equipment. This concept of C area was awarded second best paper at IEEE PCIC for its impact on safety and technology innovation. The equipment can use a globally defined C area boundary limit, and this data is used on all or specific equipment within a specified range. The range can be based on voltage and or current. In this case, let's automatically assess any equipment between 208 to 480, and with a fault current range between 0.2 to 10 kA. In IEEE 1584, the fault current exclusion limit was decreased from around 10 kA to 0.2, which historically may have drastically increased the amount of time spent on equipment within this range. With the option selected, ETAP will automatically assess equipment within these limits, removing the need to do an individual study per device and repeat studies for the same equipment within the same fault current range, saving countless amounts of hours. So if I select a panel board here, all panel boards can be globally assigned from 208 to 1 kV. We can set the voltage tolerance range, the short circuit current range that we're going to assess. I can add electrical electrode configuration, so the software will automatically compare VCBB, give you worst case conditions, implement the gap variation boundaries and the dimension working distance for all panel boards in this range, instantly allowing me to assess all equivalent panel boards. I only have to model one and quickly evaluate all in one click, which we'll soon see. Before we evaluate or make any changes, I'm going to create another layer for revision so that I can change my protective device settings in this recommended layer such that I don't override my base project at this time. Go to recommended. Now I can hit Control A and select the entire project, or I can just select a group of buses to evaluate. This opens up our automatic star auto evaluation viewer. It gives me a tabular response of protection and coordination information. Since we're focusing ArcFlash Auto, let's take a look at the ArcFlash results in this case. I can expand to see the time current coordination studies, and this will allow me to do ArcFlash within the protection and coordination mode. I don't have to switch back and forth. I don't even have to do a separate ArcFlash study. It's done completely integrated. We see that the coordination all passes in this case, but we do have some ArcFlash situations that we have to do. Let's start with bus C on the load side breaker. So we can see that there's enough space for the incident energy C area curve. And we have a passing criteria, and same with the remaining breakers within bus C on the load side. But on the bus side, on the main bus protective device side, it crosses the protective device. So we know that you cannot get below 4 calories per centimeter squared. And same thing with the line side breaker. And here we're considering not only the relay time, but the breaker trip time as well. That's all considered, which is why there is a gap shown, but it's still failing because it's incorporating the breaker time. And when we try to adjust the relay settings, this model doesn't provide any lower settings. So this is the lowest range we can go. And we know that our coordination, as we saw, is correct. So we can't adjust the relay time. However, we can balance and compromise on the accepted incident energy range of bus C. So on the bus side, we can change it to 8 calories per centimeter square. And with that change, our flash auto evaluation is automatically going to adjust its evaluation, and now you see a passing criteria. And we can do the same thing for the line side. And once you click on the auto evaluation viewer, you see the TCC is automatically updating to the appropriate TCC. And we change that line side location from 8 to 12 calories per centimeter squared, giving us a passing criteria for that location as well. And finally, we see that we have an arc duration critical limit. So the arc point damage point, the arc energy damage point is failing. It's exceeding the critical limit. So we can start off by adjusting the relay time dial settings, bringing it down and adjusting the settings, and evaluating if this change allows us to stay clear of the critical limit of the energy damage, which it does. Now we see it's that we have a passing criteria. And we have a pricing criteria in all the locations. And with that relay setting change, we can take a look at the coordination, and that is still passing as well. So it quickly allows us to evaluate arc flash and coordination at the same time. Arc flash auto evaluation drastically reduces the amount spent on an arc flash study. Now, we can consider arc flash during the short circuit protection and coordination stage. You no longer have to do your protection coordination studies, move to a separate arc flash study, and go back to your coordination to double check if your arc flash changes are valid. The C area significantly reduces the number of scenarios that you have to manually consider, incorporating all the characteristics for physical dimensions, voltage profiles, short circuit ranges. ETAP produces the worst case condition and evaluates against that scenario. The C area also reduces the labor-intensive data collection process to collect all of this information needed for IEEE 1584 for each piece of equipment. Thank you for watching this webinar, Arc Flash Auto Evaluation, and learning how to save time on future Arc Flash projects.